And so Gabriel's Horn and the Painter's Paradox is basically encapsulating the whole behavior of 1 over n squared converging as a series versus 1 over n diverging. So it all relies on that. And that in itself is mind-blowing. Like the fact that 1 over n squared, so you add 1 plus a quarter plus a ninth plus a 16th, the fact that that gives you pi squared over 6, like I don't believe it, yet I can prove it in like 10 different ways.
Is this paradox created by any mathematical sleight of hand, any problem with semantics, anything about the non-mathematical nature of paint? Or is it or is it just legit? It's just a legit thing.
The way I like to think about it is there's no mathematical sleight of hand. Like we know there is a formula for the volume of a revolution. And you just plug in this function, you get pi. There is a formula for the surface of revolution, which is a well-defined thing, and you get infinity. So mathematically, this is all completely correct. Intuitively, it's hard to get your head around, of course, which is why it's a paradox. The way I sort of come to terms with it is to say, well, because one of the arguments I've heard about this is to say, if I made it see-through, then I could fill it with paint and it would look painted from the outside. And again, that's paradox. It literally blows your mind. But the thing that's sort of missing from that is you could never actually make it, because it's infinitely long. So you could never. So that, I think that's where the paradox is, at least to me, is kind of resolved. You could never build this horn. You could make the world's longest horn, but you could never make an infinitely long horn. So the whole concept of painting something that can never exist just doesn't make sense.
That's also where the problem with filling it comes in as well. Because exactly. if you started pouring the paint in, it would never reach the bottom, ever.
Yes, yeah, very true, very true. So yeah, you would just never be able to actually do this in practice. It's very much a theoretical thing. It can never exist, but it does give you this, at least I think, pretty cool maths result.
Don't mess with infinity, man. Don't mess with infinity.
So true.
I'll try. I'm not the best at this, but I'll try and get a tone out of it.